Holy Spirit. But why do we expect to be a Holy Spirit as a God? The verse of the Father is in God's presence. And if we follow the law of the Holy Spirit, the word life means growth. That is only the mystery, the revelation of God and what is in the mystery. Life is not you bringing him down and coming to the mystery. It's like the death of the bringing him down and coming to the mystery. It's a wicked thing. So when we thought that the law of the Holy Spirit, in the life, so in these steps, we're looking at the tabernacle because it outlines some of the spiritual laws for us, called a piece of chocolate. Many times in New Testament legislation, sometimes in the New Testament, it's brought in. It now is part of our new canon that we need to read. It's part of the apostles' doctrine, it's part of Jesus Christ's doctrine, and that's been known for 19 years, and then you don't have to go to sacrifice, power, and all that stuff, but it's discovered in some of the previous books in the tabernacle. We have the obligation to sacrifice life. That your will be done in all those people who are on the earth. I get to keep my name. Your will be done in them and in them. I don't know what that means. It says something about you. So, how do you build another foundation? Do you have it? Most of those men didn't have anything to do with the tabernacle, but they just did what was required. They just did what was required to do with the tabernacle. Meeting those conditions. someone started with the achievement of putting the tabernacle in place. Whenever they got it built, God's presence descended upon it, and they could see that they were proud of that God of heaven, and they were ashamed of the story of heaven. And it's time to move, God would tell Moses, it's time to move. And if you're a bunch of grumblers, then I just had my gardens just halfway done, the work is almost ready. Then we move next month back to the Moses. Moses says, fact. And this is so important. He didn't do that out of his own experience. He just controlled because God was setting him back to Moses. We look at the Bible, we look at the culture, we look at the first-instance, the way, this is the second-instance, this is the truth. Most people who say, oh, Christians are going to be out of court because they can't assimilate the whole truth of God. By these curtains, with these money pillars standing in the center, five of them, which represents the five-fold manuscript, the gospel, the prophet, the teacher, the evangelist, the pastor, the five prophets, and those are the guys who make the bread, who do the God's presence, who do the five prophets. I find it interesting that five manuscripts are there. Two more ministries in the background. There's where you need to head to get into those ministries and where Jesus made the invitation of his ministry to grace. We come to minister to him his way in the holy place. We come to minister to him, stayed in the light. In the world, and if you're not still fresh, that you're very close to it, you get my prayer to come to you. With the same spirit to God, to the Lord. So we've been talking much about those things, some of the truth of sessions, the new sessions, we want to look at Jesus, talk about the four pillars, you can find the scripture in Ephesians chapter 3, and verse 11. When we get to see the city descending out of heaven, that's the foundation. God is the foundation. He's the prophet. We'll look at the distribution of those five levels because most people just, oh, well, five, we'll just get five. Hopefully that could be correct. The temple wasn't built that way, they were thought about such tabernacles. So we'll be looking at those two pillars in this room. So let's start with, remember we talked about the sockets, if you'll take your mind back to 100 pounds of silver that was brought, but 765 shekels of silver. Shekel is a weight. It's not necessarily coin, it's just a weight of what coin. You've got a gold earring that weighs a shekel, that's 600 measurements in weight. I say that because we've been talking a lot about the shekel. And it was equivalent, that shekel was equal to 2 days' labor in the summer. If we're going to convert, we have to convert what the coin would be worth to find out what the half-shekel was. And that we need to, since we talked about the foundation, remember, we've got to lay the foundation first. That's why when we started this off, before they put up the linen fence and all that stuff, they backed up the setup stuff, and they unload all these silver blocks that weigh, in my opinion, 125 pounds. Two. Where the talent weighs, the royal talent, any time you can be with the poor people in Jeff's place. Everybody else that was commonly extended, the royal Cuban was about 12 or 30 centuries ago, about 22 inches from the scripture, about 18. So, maybe a bit different, but let's look for a moment of where that silver, the silver was not taken as just you bring something and you get something back. It's the foundation. And if you believe in the symbolism of the tabernacle, then it was something that happened special with that silver. Those silver is special for other things, but this silver had a specific use to be taken in a specific way because it represented a specific thing. Whatever it is, okay? The silver of the socket for the foundation of the tabernacle. Remember, the new tabernacle too. I'm going to get it when I get home. I like my wife. My wife said out there, so y'all have reason to pray. Maybe all the way to next Tuesday. So let's read some scripture and then we'll talk to the place. Okay? Numbers 1, 45 through 46. So all the numbered men of the sons of Israel by their father's household, in 20 years old. Whoever was able to go out to war and bring Israel, even all the numbered men, 603,550. To do something with what these men were supposed to bring, what these men were supposed to bring. So Exodus 30, 12, and 14, or 3, 14. When you take a census of the sons of Israel, number them, then each one of them shall give as a ransom for themselves to the Lord. When you number them so that there will be no problem in them, when you number them, three times you can number them. So it's a genuine command. The author of the Godhead saying, get them numbered. And this has to do with you stopping in any place in your life. Now, where did the place come from? One of the places was that the firstborn. Everybody that didn't have the blood over the door was to die. They put the blood over the door, and now God is saying, you have the blood over the door. I passed over you. You need to pay the ransom for me giving you life. You agree with me? Because that's what half shekel was. So this is what everyone who is numbered shall get. A half shekel, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, the shekel is 20 gerahs. A half shekel as a contribution to the Lord. Everyone who is numbered from 20 years older and over shall give a contribution to the Lord. Set so low that no matter how poor you were, you could pay. And no matter how rich you were, you weren't supposed to fit in something else for somebody else. It had to be done precisely the way it was. Were there more silver than it is? Yes. But there was something special that needed to be done with this silver. It goes on in Exodus 38, 25 through 28. The silver of the congregation who were numbered was 100 talents and 1775 shekels. It's 100 talents, 125 pounds per talent of silver, plus a leftover 1775 shekels. according to the shepherd of the sanctuary. A deacon, a head, it is a false shepherd. Deacon means cut in half. So the shepherd, the temple shepherd, is he's saying cut in half, and he's supposed to be put together. For each one who passed over to those who were numbered from 20 years old, and I think there's something there to get, there's something 3,500. You know, people, don't lose details, don't you? The 100 pounds of silver was the casting socket of the sanctuary. Those sockets of the sanctuary, we're not talking about the half quarts. We're talking about the sockets that were laid as the foundation. There's 100 of those that were made. Plus, there was a 1,775 seconds that was left for making some top hoops for the hips, the little circles that held the top together, and for decorating the columns on the inside, and for the posts that were inside. There was four posts that were inside that separated the holy place. Ten cubits by 20 cubits. My mind, about to make the choir. Probably about 20 feet wide and 40 feet high. The second place is 10 by 10, but 10 cubits. About 10 cubits. You can see a whole bunch of things. We didn't want to change the dimensions. Actually, we lived in two of them. The silver of the congregation is numbered with the number of dollars. I don't know if you get that. So, now, the 100 pounds of silver, those 27, were for casting socks of sanctuary in the socket of the veil. 100 sockets for each 100 pounds. For a socket. He's talking about the base for the socket. Of 1,775 shekels, he made hooks for pillars and overlaid the top and made bands for this. Now, I think this is probably the most correct method we use in our table. You see the orange socket that you bear in the front of the tabernacle. All the rest of the sockets of white. I personally think this is more correct than the bands, because when you approach the temple, at the face of it, you add a port. There's two posts that were used on the outside, three ports. Then there were three posts that the veil was in. Because if it's raining and if you've got to do something, you're standing in the port. Now keep in mind, when it's erecting the temple that's down the hill, it's a tabernacle. And you think that God would have changed the status of its outside design. And if he didn't change it, then this is the pattern that the temple was built in, that before you went in the holy place, there was kind of a port there that you went. And under that port, they're going to put on the rest of your vest, and you ever wonder, well, did you stand out there in the dirt in the dust storm and put on the turban and put on all the stuff? No, all that stuff is hanging ready in this area, ready for him to be ministered to by the rest of the Levites to get him dressed so that he can go in. You realize the Levites didn't go into this place. Only the sons of Aaron went into this place. The Levites served in the outer court of the priest, chopping the wood, burning the wood, making the fire, cooking the fire. I saw a picture of a brave altar, and the dean from Texas, I really love smoking meat. I mean, it takes a long time to smoke a meat. But I also did some burnt sacrifices. They really didn't take minutes long to cook enough wood. And I learned, okay, I've got to slow down the oxygen intake. But if you wanted to raise the level of the heat to get rid of it, I used to, and I still do, and I do, I turn up the heat until it's about 800 degrees. It burns off everything you do. to open the lid, let it peel off. If there's anything left in it, if there's any grease left in there, you better stand back and you won't have eyelashes. I'm speaking from experience. And I just got the biggest giggle out of working on the person. There's something to building a fire. You can ask a friend of mine that remembers the law. A dear friend of mine one time, let me say that for you. I can't remember. You picked the wrong one. Now, you can ask, but he was serious. So I followed him out there and watched how he eyeballed and picked them. And he was the way he picked them. That's not the way I picked them. The way he sat them was not the way I sat them. And finally, after about 4 years, I said, dear friend, would you let me show you how maybe you rearrange that because it's not as much smoke? He was nice enough, and I think all those things. And soon after, I showed him how to do this cross-section. And he didn't mean to be here, and he didn't mean to be here. The shovel, the space shovel. So let's get back to the sanctuary. You can see the shaded socket. There was 100 of them. Exactly 100. You can see the size of the sanctuary. And here's the thing. These blocks of silver were weighed, in my opinion, 125 pounds a piece. The bottom of your screen up there, these are stones. What do you think they were laid on? Now, I found out something about dirt. You can actually talk to dirt. If you contacted us, and I went out there and there was a lot of action that was to do every day, 6 times a day, women go by to take all the water, come to the water, and it's just dirt. The women sweep it and all that stuff, and when they get to the end of the course of dirt about the sick, that it's hard. It's so desperate. And even around the house, the ground is sprinkled in the house for about 22 days. It's just so desperate. And you do what? So it's just like, you know, justice, which is up to your toes.